Geographic tongue.
Dorsal, lateral, ventral tongue. Adult patient with this pattern. What do we think? Okay. Preference, the preferred diagnosis is going to be erythema migraine. If you put geographic tongue down, you still get it right. And migratory velocitis, you get it. Adult patient, we have an asymptomatic brown color alteration, lower lip mucosa. Homogeneous, well-defined, less than 5 millimeters. Most likely diagnosed.
Melanoma?
Well, this could be a melanocytic mucosa. That's true. Most likely, though, would be less likely. It most likely would be focal melanosis. Now, you know, if you're put down melanocytic nevus, I'd probably count that full breadth. Yeah, where else do we see focal areas of increased melanin pigmentation in the oral cavity?
Focal mucosa.
Just about any place. Attached gingiva, palate,
that's an amazing beard.
But lips, the lip mucosa is one of the more common locations for this entity. Okay, so we have an adult patient, exophytic mass of gingiva involving the interdental papilla. You can see the color, most likely diagnosed. There are several other alternative diagnoses that we see that can absolutely look like this clinically. And if you were to put them down, you'd get credit as well. But the most likely is pyogenic granuloma. Well, if you've ruled out that this is an abscess, it is not going to return. So these usually come up fairly quickly and get to the size they're going to really quickly. So if I saw this patient in the clinic, it might take 2 weeks to get it removed, but I'm going to already get an appointment for that patient.
What did you say to the patient?
What's that?
Differential?
Well, you all tell me.
Metastatic.
What?
Metastatic.
Lateral periodontal abscess.
Okay, but let's say we've ruled that out. Did I hear metastatic from someone?
Metastatic tumor.
They can look just like that. One of the more common locations for metastatic disease of the oral cavity. What else? Back to Dr.